check. Brothers and sisters, the show you are about to listen to contains explicit content. The Scrap Pile Podcast is a blend of politics, comedy, music, and opinion, exposing the erosions of our freedoms. Bully cops, crooked politicians, and all other puppet masters, you have been warned. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Scrap Pile! Let me clear my throat! What is up, ladies and gentlemen? It is Mystery back in the studio for another Scrap Pile Podcast. ScrapPilePodcast.com. Find Mystery on Twitter, M-I-Z-T-I-R-E. That's me. Also, follow me on Facebook. Scrap Pile Podcast is now available on iTunes. I got a short show for you today. I'm going to cover three things. One of them is a law that lets the IRS seize accounts on suspicion. No crime required. No charges. None of that. And I know a lot of people hate Obamacare, and I'm going to tell you how to get out of it. There's a real simple way. I'm going to give you a few ways, but there's one really, really simple way. And on a lighter side, Aaron Lewis, he used to be the front man for Stained. Now he sings country music with his national anthem blunder, which I'm not going to beat him up too bad about it because I couldn't imagine standing in front of that many people and trying to sing that song because it... Francis Scott Key wrote a hell of a song there, and you got to be a beast just to sing it. I mean, to sing it good. You know what? I should sing it just to see how hard it is. Who knows? Who knows? I might even try to give it a shot. All right, but first, which one do you want to hear first? This one here really gets to me. The law that lets the IRS seize accounts on suspicion. No crime required. And this is actually from the New York Times, Arnold's Park, Iowa. For almost 40 years, Carol Hinders has dished out Mexican specialties at her modest cash-only restaurant. For just as long, she deposited the earnings at a small bank branch a block away until last year when two tax agents knocked on her door and informed her that they had seized her checking account, almost $33,000. The Internal Revenue Service agents did not accuse Ms. Hinders of money laundering or cheating on her taxes. In fact, she has not been charged with any crime. Instead, the money was seized solely because she had deposited less than $10,000 at a time. Now, anybody that's ever dealt any drugs knows that you don't deposit. Once you deposit $10,000, it triggers the IRS. So a lot of times they'll have, you know, multiple bank accounts and just keep it under 10 grand. But since she did that, they viewed that as an attempt to avoid triggering a required government report. How can this happen, Ms. Henders said in a recent interview. Who takes your money before they prove that you've done anything wrong with it? Well, that'd be the Fed. The federal government does. Using a law designed to catch drug traffickers, racketeers, and terrorists by tracking their cash, the government has gone after run-of-the-mill business owners and wage earners without so much as an allegation that they have committed serious crimes. The government can take the money without ever filing a criminal complaint, and the owners are left to prove that they are innocent. Many give up. Because you're guilty till proven innocent, people! In the land of the free. They can just take your money, folks. You know, the whole... You're supposed to be tried by a jury of your peers and all that, right to trial, speedy trial by a jury and all that. But it just seems like they're just erasing all that, just slowly taking it away. And they'll just take your shit and you got to prove, to get it back, you got to prove to them that you didn't do anything wrong. And sometimes that's very hard to do. Like I've had, like even with YouTube, I've had to prove I've made a video. Instead of them saying, like they'll try to hit me for a copyright sometimes. And instead of saying, hey, that's copyrighted by so-and-so, they say, instead of that, it's I just had to prove that I made it. And I don't know how to do that. You know, all I can do is, I don't know, send somebody over and I'll show them my files, I guess. I don't fucking know. How do I prove that this is me talking and that I recorded it and put it out there? I don't know. You want to read the rest of the story, I'll put a link in the description so you can read the rest of it. But just watch out. That's like that one story that... I think it was Bank of America. It might have been a different bank. But they foreclosed on this guy's house, and he didn't even have a loan on the house. And then when he went to court, he lost. Because it just they side with the banksters, man. It's what they do. All right. Enough of that story. It's just another way Big Brother's sticking it to the man. Or sticking it to the people. It's just another way to Big Brother sticking it to the people, man. In the land of the fucking free. All right, here's a little bit on Obamacare. I'm just going to read a little bit of this article because I can kind of skip through some of it and just tell you in a very easy way to opt out. A lot of people don't, and you know, because you will get fined, or they like to call it a penalty. I like to call it a fine at the end of, you know, on your taxes if you don't sign up for Obamacare. And which brings me to another point. Turn your phone off, Bobby. I'm trying to do the damn podcast. But God damn it, Bobby. All right, but look. This is what I was thinking about Obamacare. I never got a letter in the mail. I never got an email, a phone call. Nothing to even tell me to sign up for this shit. Now, I knew you were supposed to because I look at a bunch of news. But there's a lot of people. I know a lot. Shit, 90% of the people I know don't give two shits about the news. They don't listen to no podcasts. They don't listen to no talk shows. They don't watch news on TV or subscribe to any social media. I mean, there's some people that just don't give a shit about none of that shit. And I envy them a lot. I wish I could be more like that. But once you're awake, it's hard to insert yourself back in the matrix. I've been trying. But I just wonder how would you find somebody for that? And hell, they didn't know. Can you tell me what the deadline was? You probably can, but hell, I can't even think of it. I don't know. I didn't sign up for this shit. Ways to get out of it. For millions of Americans, time is running out to get qualifying health insurance coverage under the Patient Protection and Affordable Care Act, better known as Obamacare. Yet even though penalties under Obamacare for not having coverage can be expensive for many families, what many don't know is that there are extensive exemptions that could prevent you from having to pay those penalties. I'm going to just skip down to the ways to get out of it. All right, here's a few of the exemptions. The death of a close family member. Now, to qualify for these, you have to go to, you got to fill out the hardship exemption application form, which I'm going to, it's from the government's health insurance marketplace website. And I will link this story that I'm getting this from, so you can find this if you need to use that. All right, but here's some of the ways. The death of a close family member. Having medical expenses that could pay at some point in the past 2 years. Having unexpected higher costs from caring for a family member. Having a child denied for Medicaid and Children's Health Insurance Program coverage, with another person required to provide medical support to the child. Denial of Medicaid because your state didn't expand its Medicaid program. Notice of cancellation of existing insurance, with other plans being unaffordable. Haven't gotten a favorable eligibility appeals notice. And this here's my favorite one. Getting a shutoff notice from a utility. That's the easiest one, folks. If you don't qualify for none of those other ones, don't pay your fucking electric bill. Wait till you get the shutoff notice, then pay it. And then once you have that shutoff notice, bam. Fill out this thing and you're exempt. It's that simple, Bobby. Just don't pay your electric bill till you get a shutoff notice. But don't wait too long after you get that, because they will shut your power off. All right, moving right along. I want to get into the Aaron Lewis Star-Spangled Blunder. Now, when I first heard it, I had to listen to it kind of close. Because, well, for one thing, I it took a second to find out what the fuck-up was, and then it was really obvious. Because, I don't know, it's just a hard song. Like I said, I couldn't imagine having to sing this song in front of thousands and thousands of people, especially at a World Series or a Super Bowl. Because remember, Christina Aguilera fucked it up. Carl Lewis, I got all these clips, and I got a top 10 that I got from SportsCenter. But I was going to go really light on the guy because I understand it's a difficult thing, especially a cappella, no music, just singing. It's just you, all eyes on you. But when I was downloading the clip, I found another clip of him trashing Christina Aguilera for doing the exact same shit. So first, let's just run the clip of Aaron Lewis singing the national anthem. Run that clip, Bobby.
And now to perform the national anthem, please welcome singer, songwriter, multi-platinum dot recording artist, Aaron Lewis.
Oh, say can you see? By the dawn's
hard song to sing, folks. But yeah, he screwed the words up. And like I said, I was going to take it easy. I'm still not going to beat the guy up too bad. But listen to this clip. This was after Christina Aguilera, which I'm going to play that clip too. But this is what he said on stage about her doing the exact same shit. Bobby, clip please.
Okay, better than Christina. Or was that Cyndi Lauper? I'm not really sure who. I don't understand how people that sing the national anthem can be so fucking self-absorbed that they would try to change that fucking song. If there's a single song in the history of this country that deserves no creative interpretation, it's that one.
All right. He seems to think that Christina Aguilera intentionally changed the words, which I don't think she did. I think she's horrible. I just don't understand that whole singing style. Sing. Shut up. All right, Bobby, roll the Christina Aguilera clip.
To honor America, 5-time Grammy Award winner, Christina Aguilera.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight was so proudly we watched at the twilight's last gleaming.
All right. I got a few more. We're not done yet. I got several more. These are two of my favorite fuck-ups. And I'm not mad at these guys. I'm not mad at none. I'm not mad at Christina Aguilera or Aaron Lewis. I know it's a high-pressure fucking situation. And some would argue that they should be used to it because that's what they do. You know, they've performed in front of lots of people, rock stars and all that shit, pop divas and country stars and all that. Okay, yeah, maybe they should, but it's got to be a lot of pressure. The whole world's watching. It's different when you're just doing a show in front of who's there, but when you know the whole world's fucking watching. And that song's hard to sing. All right, but these, I blame whoever booked these people to sing. All right, I got two. I got Roseanne Barr and Carl Lewis. Which one you got queued up, Bobby? Here's Carl Lewis, the national anthem. The Star-Spangled Banner interpretation by Carl Lewis, gold medalist Olympian.
For the ramparts we watch, we're so gallant.
dreaming. And the Rockets, red flag. Uh-oh. The bombs bursting in a gate through the night. That a black was still there. I'll make up for it now.
That it's so funny. All right, here, and here's Roseanne Barr. She's just a comedian, folks. I don't know who booked Carl Lewis or Roseanne Barr, but I hit it, Bobby. Here's Roseanne Barr, Star Spangled Banner.
Stripes and bright stars, silver perilous fight, are the ramparts we watch, where so gallantly streaming, and the
But someone booked her without her even trying out, I guess. I don't know. All right, like I said at the beginning, follow Mr. E on Twitter at M-I-Z-T-I-R-E. Scrap Pile Podcast now available on iTunes, Stitcher, where else? All over the place. Find me on Facebook, M-I-Z-T-I-R-E, Scrap Pile Podcast on Facebook. And I believe that's going to wrap it up, folks. That's the end of the show. Bobby, hit that switch. This is Mr. E, and I'm out this bitch.